Hello guys and welcome back to a brand new review. If you are new to the channel, please make sure you're gonna subscribe. It's gonna really help out the channel. In today's video, we're gonna have a look at the brand new Nike Vaporfly Next Percent 2, which as you can see, it got a very good improvement for the upper, and also had a price cut, so I guess this shoe really became more attractive for a lot of people since it got released end of March. So it's relatively new on the market, this new version. So as you can see, we have a brand new upper made out of a new mesh, which is very similar to the one used in the actual Alpha Fly. You can see it here in the corner. It's not entirely the same, but it's very similar. But to be honest, comparing to the older model, which I have it here, you can see that the material is completely changed. We're gonna do a separate review for the actual changes between these two, so make sure you're gonna subscribe to the channel. So as I was saying, the upper material was completely changed. The lacing system, which is a bit offset, it's the same, but the actual laces got an improvement, which it appears that it will keep your foot in place much better. Then here at the front, we got another improvement as well. As in with the old one, you didn't have this rubberized guard here. So this time, I guess this whole front section of the shoe will be much better. And here at the tongue section, they decided to put a little bit of foam, so this will feel much better when you're gonna tighten your shoelaces. Inside, as you can see, we have the same foam padding here for the heel section, so that wasn't changed at all. But just above it, we got a slight improvement with this bit of material. And then going to the actual midsole, Nike decided to keep it as in the previous model, which was a very clever move, as this midsole, the ZoomX, it's very, very good and it's used in a lot of running shoes from Nike. So that it's not changed. So as you know, you have this ZoomX foam, and at the middle you have the carbon plate, which will give you that spring effect. So I'm really glad that they decided to keep it, as I know it from the previous model that the response was very, very good. And then finishing here with the sole, it didn't change again, it's completely the same like in the previous one, with this big rubber here and then with the two small here at the back, which for me, to be honest, it's kind of strange that they've put just these two small rubber ones here, as you have this foam very exposed. So as you use it, let's say on a small trail, you're gonna have a lot of rocks piercing through this foam, so it will be damaged. Of course, this shoe is not made for trails, but of course you'll try to use it at some point. So please keep in mind that this foam will be pierced quite easily. as in for the sizing, I've went to my true to size, and the biggest change that Nike decided to do with this shoe is that the price went down from 239 to 209. So Nike made it slightly affordable. I'm really glad that they actually did that. So overall, I'm really glad that they actually changed this upper material. I wasn't a big fan of the previous one, which was like a rubberized, like a plastic bag, or it was very strange, to be honest. I'm really glad that they decided to go with this breathable mesh. You can really feel the air going through. And then with these laces, again, very good laces. Yeah, this shoe, even though it's a size 10, it's not heavy at all. It's around 212 grams, which is very, very good, given the size of the actual shoe. So yeah, I really hope you've enjoyed this video. If you did, don't forget to subscribe to the channel. I will drop a video very soon with the actual differences between this and the original Vaporfly Next Percent. So don't forget to like and subscribe to the channel, and as always, I will see you in my next one. Thanks for watching.